Welcome, everyone. Good evening. Welcome to this first midweek Lenten worship. We will be doing Hold an Evening Prayer, so I hope each person has a little book so you can follow along. We also have a reflection in the middle of it, and then we will have communion as well. So thank you for everyone being here. We're all good, it looks like. Come to you. That wouldn't matter. Go ahead. What? No, everybody does it. Yeah.
Jesus Christ, you are the light of the world. Stay with us now, for it is evening. Let your light scatter the darkness. Thank you.
our prayers come before you, O God, as incense, and may your presence surround and fill us, so that in unison with all creation, we might sing your praise and your love in our lives. Amen. So we have a reading from the Gospel of John, one of your favorites. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. So we will be having this reading also for this weekend. So I thought I'd give a little introduction. We can remember hearing these words in many sporting events. You can put on your helmet and run into the end zone and praise God that he gave me the gift to do this. Remember that? And a little guy named Tim Tebow. Come on, guys. Wake up. But they reach much deeper in our lives in this earthly kingdom and also in our faith lives. These are the words of such a powerful and impactful love from a God that gave his only Son to die for humanity. And this is a God that came down to live amongst us, to feel our pain, to know who you are, to know who we are, and to eventually bring us eternal life. And yes, friends, that is what we are beginning to reflect on in this Lenten journey. So take a second and think about that. I invite you to close your eyes and think about what an impactful, amazing gift this is. So let us pray. Loving God, thank you for coming into this world for our sake. Be with us now as we move together as community through this season of Lent, and as we come to your eventual resurrection on Easter Sunday. We give you thanks for all of this. And all of God's people said, amen. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
For peace and salvation we pray to you. For peace between nations, for peace between peoples. For us who are gathered to worship and praise you. Servants who live out your gospel. For all those who govern that justice might guide them. For all those who labor in service together. Weather that nourishes all of creation. Keep watch on our loved ones and keep us from danger. For all the beloved who rest in your mercy. Comfort us all of our days.
Great and merciful God, source and ground of all goodness and life, give to your people the peace that passes all understanding, and that will to live your gospel of mercy and justice through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rise as you are able. You are indeed holy and almighty and merciful God. You are most holy and great is the majesty of your glory. You so loved the world that you gave your only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. We give you thanks for his coming into the world to fulfill for us your holy will and to accomplish all things for our salvation. It's for that reason, in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his salutary command and his life-giving passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and the promise of his coming again, we give you thanks, O Lord God Almighty, not as we ought, but as we are able. We ask you mercifully to accept our praise and thanksgiving, and with your word and Holy Spirit to bless us, your servants, and these your own gifts of bread and wine, so that we and all who share in this body and blood of Christ may be filled with heavenly blessing and grace, and receiving the forgiveness of sin, may be formed to live as your holy people and be given our inheritance with all your saints. To you, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory in your holy church, now and forever. Coming together as one universal church, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Invite you now to take inventory of yourself, and when you are ready, please come forward, for the feast is now prepared. Mm-hmm.
Christ be ever light for our lives. May the Spirit of love